All kids out of the pool for Adult Swim. All kids out.
HBOs. At 8 o'clock, we got Real Sex 41, then we switched to Taxicab Confessions 10, then over to Autopsy 7.
I'm glad I'm paying for satellite instead of health insurance.
Good evening, guys. Andy, I don't want to bother you, so thanks for the gift. I'll put the receipt on your desk.
Wait. I gave you a gift?
Well, I'm getting straight A's this quarter. Mom and Dad always bought me a gift for that.
You don't live with Mom and Dad anymore.
Right. And since you've taken over for them, I got myself a treat on your behalf. A great new computer game.
Sweetheart, here in the real world, you don't get a present just for doing your job. I paid the electric bill. Nobody got me a gift. Like I said, I paid the electric bill. If you want a gift, have some electricity. It's on me.
You're not being very supportive. I hope you're not like this during parent-teacher conferences tonight.
Hi, I'm not sure we've met. Andy French? Couldn't care less about your education.
No, you have to go. Mom and Dad said you're supposed to do everything they normally do.
Okay. Well, why don't you go hop into bed, and I'll be in a moment to sprinkle talcum powder on your ass.
Hmm. Mom and Dad would like to speak to you.
Hey, you two! How's life in Wyoming?
What's this about you emotionally abusing Kevin?
Nothing, Mom, but I can't suddenly change my life around
just because Kevin's here. I have plans for tonight.
Mom, he's drinking on the couch with Jim.
Hey, Mrs. F.
I'm Andy French. You know where I'm supposed to be, or...
Andy French? Oh, you must be Kevin's father.
No, I'm not his father. I'm...
Guess who I am.
Wow. Some teacher or something?
I'm Toby's mom.
Toby?
You know Toby, Kevin's best friend. And with George, the three of them are the limit. I call them the Jelly Boys. Oh, Eileen, Howard. These are George's parents. Howard runs the market on Avenue 3.
Hey, I know you. Malt liquor box of bugles.
I know you too. No credit, pay now.
Andy, I hope you'll consider joining us in the PTA. Oh, it could be a real hoot.
I don't join clubs unless they rent pornographic videotapes. Call me if you get some.
Hey, when's Andy coming back?
Probably not for a few hours.
Oh, then how about you? You want to go up on the roof and get toasted?
I'm not much of a toaster, but thanks anyway. Would you like to take a look at my new game?
Yes. My answer would have to be yes.
You start the game as a Viking warrior. The more people you kill, the stronger you become, until finally you can afford your own Viking army and a fortress. And you play on the internet with other gamers. Toby, George, and I are going to team up and go on a killing rampage.
You kids are lucky, man. All I had was the Boy Scouts.
Hey, ready to go rampaging?
Okay, just a minute.
horsemen headed your way. Kill them, Toby.
I don't know how. What do I do? What do I do? Help me.
Oh, I'll do it.
Sorry, I panicked. That Norseman looked just like my grandpa.
Ugh. Look, if we're going to be an effective horde, you're going to have to get your act together. Man, I can't wait for George to get up and running.
Mom's been using you, hasn't she?
Garden looks great, Posey. Expecting a big harvest?
Oh, yeah. There were even more vegetables yesterday, but the police were chasing a suspect across the roof and some got trampled. But even so, there are more than we could ever possibly eat.
Hey, I have an idea. Why don't you sell them? Start your own business. People pay top dollar for organic vegetables.
Oh, wow, that's a great idea. I was going to give them to charity, but where is the fun in that? I want to make some money.
Kevin's doing great. Excellent student, blah, blah, blah. You want to hear this stuff?
Not really, no.
Great. We still got 14 minutes. If only more parents were like you.
Please have a seat. I'm Miss Peck.
French. Andy French. I'm Kevin's. Brother, Kevin's brother. We both, came from the same mother.
Well, I must say it's a joy to teach Kevin. For a transfer student, he caught up very quickly. He has a college-level grasp of literature and an extremely advanced vocabulary. Mr. French?
Hmm?
Do you have any questions?
Yes. Don't I know you from somewhere? Borchmore College, class of 96?
In 1996, I was in the Marines, serving with UN forces in Bosnia-Herzegovina.
Ah, lucky Serbs.
I think this conference is over.
Wait, what are you doing this weekend? Maybe we could go to a movie?
I don't think so. Have you been drinking?
Many times, but I'm always up for more. You want to go knock back a few?
Thank you for coming. Goodbye.
No, wait. We need to talk.
Frankly, Mr. French, I'm amazed Kevin's doing as well as he is, given the total lack of parental involvement and responsibility.
Hey, I'm totally involved and responsible. There's nothing I wouldn't do for Kevin.
I knew it! So can we count on you to join the PTA?
Sure. Sign me up right now.
Wonderful. We could use one more on the cleanup committee.
Ugh. Have fun in there. Good night.
Gross. There's lipstick on that chicken.
Ugh. You're right. What's all that?
Flyers for a PTA meeting I'm hosting. I joined up to impress Kevin's hot English teacher.
Nice job. If I was a girl, I'd sleep with you.
Oh, excuse me, Gus? Who would I speak to about produce sales?
Produce? Those things look like rocks.
Oh, okay. Yeah, no, they're not rock. These are organic vegetables, quite delicious and healthy, and they make great salads.
At his joint, we don't have much call for salad. Some joker wants one, I just dug up a cabbage with some of his hot dog relish. Hey! Anybody here want a salad? Sorry, sweetheart. Come back with a basket full of hog's brains, we'll talk.
Toby, you were supposed to be guarding our fortress! What happened?
Where are you?
No!
A Norse slave trader approaches. What is your command? Sell Toby.
Andy, some people are here to see you.
People.
Get your sunny side up, sleepyhead. Put on your happy cap and...
Now, as for the fall dance, does anyone have any suggestions for the entertainment?
Well, I, for one, love square dancing. We could decorate the gym with bales of hay and have a hoedown.
We can't afford hoes. Why not something cheap like one-man band from Street Corner? He play for nickels.
I've got a connection at the Yiddish Violin Academy. Those kids will play just for the exposure.
Yeah. Holy crap.
Something you'd like to add, Mr. French?
But the stuff you're talking about is totally lame. Our kids will hate it.
Well, what do you suggest?
Well, look, for practically nothing, you can get a good DJ. One who plays music the kids actually like. You know what I mean?
I haven't listened to much popular music since that sniper took out our radio in Sarajevo.
Ooh, yeah. Well, trust me, if there's one thing I know, it's young people and how to nurture them.
Let's nurture our children, folks.
Nurture.
I tell you, George, Virtual Valkyrie has changed my life. You don't know what you're missing.
I do. I still can't get it installed.
Dirty backstabber. You sold me into slavery.
Hey, Toby, you snooze, you lose.
But you too shall snooze, old friend. And when you leave your computer for even a second, I will wreak my horrible revenge. By Odin, I am coming for you.
Little help?
Hey, stop! Give it back!
Yo, look, Dancing Queen wants his disco ball.
Come on, let's see you shake your fruity booty.
Shouldn't you two be in class? Could you use a hand here?
Sure.
So, I've heard Kevin talking about his girlfriend in Canada. Think you might bring her down for the dance?
No, she's made up. They broke up. It was rough, but, I helped him through it.
Kevin's lucky to have you. Well, see you two Saturday.
Miss Peck?
Howard, would you like to buy some of my homegrown vegetables? They're only 30 cents each.
Ah, I already got plenty of vegetable and salad bar. See? Pickled beets, crouton, bacon beets, you name it.
Yeah, perhaps if you tasted one of mine.
Burns! Take your health food out of here!
Sasha, look! They've got Indonesian mandrake root! Ooh, and kohlrabi bulbs!
Oh, yeah, just birthed from Mother Earth this morning, Sasha!
Oh my God! Is that real dirt? How much are they?
Those not for sale yet. She a wholesaler. Okay, I'll buy all your vegetables. 30 cents, right?
Oh, yeah, okay. No, not anymore. Now they're $2 each.
You crazy! Get out of store! Expensive, dirty vegetables. Hey, George! Sorayira yoke! Sarabaya porio!
Hey, Cal, we really spruced up that old gem. You will not recognize it at the dance.
I'm not going to any dance.
What? You have to go! What kind of a parent am I gonna look like showing up at the dance without my own kid?
I can't leave my computer. If I do, Toby will kill me. And God only knows what George is planning.
Yes! Well, I for one cannot believe you'd rather bury your nose in that darn computer than go to a dance and meet some nice girls.
I hate dances, okay? Girls don't like me, no one will dance with me, so I'm not going. The end.
I just think it's important for a young man's development.
Look, I've got more important things to do than obsess over women. Hey, my concubines are here.
What if I find you a date? If I find you a date, will you go?
Sure, whatever. Beat it.
Beat it? Come on, I'm busting my ass for you, and I deserve some respect. Would you talk to Mom and Dad like that?
No, but you would.
Good point.
pro skater. Now everyone thinks they can skate like Tony.
I have never known a time when my world was not at war. I suspect conspiracy. The government thinks I'm a threat. They're right.
Uncover an epic story of truth and deception. Expose the conspiracy. Capture the truth. Beyond Good and Evil. Rated T for teen.
Kevin's got a lot to offer, Andy. I bet he could find a date on his own.
I can't take that chance. He has to have a decent date if I'm going to impress Miss Peck. Now focus.
Hey, ladies. Anybody want a date for the dance?
Ew!
Huh. That's odd. I didn't even mention Kevin.
Hi. How'd you like a date to the dance Saturday night?
I'd love it! Only my dad says I'm not allowed to date until I'm 14. Wait, here he comes. Let me ask him.
I'm trying to find my brother a date for the dance, and I'm willing to pay for it. Any takers?
What I gotta do?
Oh, nothing like that. One dance, a cup of punch at most.
$100.
$100? $50.
$50? What's he look like? $200. And no slow dances.
Squash!
I love it.
Oh, your kicks rock.
Tell your friends about me.
Okay, that's it. You people get away from my store. I call police.
Hey, pal. Let her sell her vegetables. It's a free country. At least it used to be.
Just another case of the man trying to keep us down.
I'm not the man. He keep me down, too.
Save it for the country club, Thurston.
Okay, you win. I buy all your crazy expensive vegetables.
Oh, great. Okay, I'm glad we could work this out, Howard. I will also need a 40% franchising bonus, a small shelving fee, and of course an exclusive point of purchase display to maintain my brand integrity.
Okay, but next time you need tampon late at night, forget it.
You've really outdone yourself, honey. Those are beautiful cupcakes.
Yeah, I frosted each one in a different style. Cubist, Dada, Russian Constructivist.
Thanks for helping out with the food. Really appreciate it. Kevin, let's go! Come on, chop chop, let's get the show on the... What is this?
It's called fortifying your defenses.
Oh, no, no. We're off to the big dance. Look at you, your hair's a mess.
Let go of me! Stop! I can't see my battle lines!
You want to look good for your date, don't you? Here, this'll match your slacks.
Let's be rational. Dances are voluntary activities that...
Someday, you'll thank me for this. Now buck up, smile... Look like you're having fun, especially if Miss Peck walks by.
Fun? Sure, I'll just chit-chat over punch while Toby's army beheads me and mounts my face on a pike.
That's the spirit.
Andy, everything looks wonderful.
Hey, when you travel Air French, you travel first class.
Maybe later I can visit the cockpit. I'm sorry, we didn't flirt much in the Marines.
You're doing fine. So, how about a dance?
I've got some work to do, but I'd love to later.
Work. Right. Chaperoning. I'm on it. Hey, what do you think you're doing? Can you believe that?
I'll take care of it.
Whoa, 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 whoa! None of that in here. You take it outside.
Toby's away from his computer. That means nobody's defending his fortress.
Hey, how's my little jolly boy? Having a good time?
No, let me go. Come on, I'm in a big hurry.
Toby, my baby!
Listen to me. We're going to find Miss Peck, and you're going to tell her I'm a loving, caring brother, or I'll kick your ass. I didn't mean that. Please don't call Mom.
Young man, my kitty cat is stuck up in that tree.
Sorry, it was already dead.
Ready for that dance yet, Miss Peck?
Sure. And Andy, it's Colleen.
Come on, keep pedaling. You can do it.
I'm doing it, Daddy. I'm biking all by myself.
Aha!
Your fort is going down. My navy's gonna blast you.
Yeah, your navy and what army?
You know, Andy, when I first met you, I didn't think much of you.
Oh, thank you.
I thought you were an immature, selfish slacker, but you really proved me wrong. You're caring and responsible and a terrific parent.
So, maybe I'm your type after all.
Maybe you are.
There he is! Yo, where's my money?
What money?
He said he'd give me $200 to go out on a date.
$200? It was $50.
Don't you disrespect my bitch.
Andy, you paid this girl?
I just wanted my brother to have a good time. Not that good a time.
Rocky! Rolls! That's him! That's the pervert who tried to pick me up yesterday!
Look, I was just trying to be a good, caring parent. The kind you like. This whole time, I've only been looking out for Kevin.
I'm a dead man.
Isn't that cute? Little guy's all tuckered out.
Ow. Andy, it hurts to walk.
What do you want me to do about it? I can't believe I'm being nice to you and no one's around to appreciate it.
I appreciate it.
What's that smell?
I fell in the sewer.
Bill Oakley, Josh Weinstein Production.
Ah! All kids out of the pool for adult swim. All kids out. Skull.
No diving in an empty pool. No diving. No diving.
Marco!
Marco! Adult Swim! Adults! Adult Swim! Adult Swim!
C-Lab 2021, next. 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 Aqua Teen Hunger Force. Aqua Teen Hunger Force is next.
I don't know. It's another word for pool. Sounds fancy, I guess. Harvey Birdman, attorney at law, next. Almost there. Reach for it, ladies. No peeking, Betty. Reach for it, ladies.
No tea parties. No tea parties. Somebody's gonna get hurt. Come on. Grow up.
Sir, I thought we said no cannonballs. Sir.
You know, Ethel, Bartersville's got just the peace and quiet George and I were looking for. And the students are so well behaved.
It's August. The students aren't here yet.
Welcome, students. Oh, that's nice.
Take a look around, Mr. Buckles. This is our new home. Wake up, Mr. Buckles. We're here.
Didn't you poke holes in the lid so Mr. Buckles could breathe?
Quiet. You're scaring Mr. Buckles.
So, have you given any thought to what you want to do with your life, son?
Duh. You've heard my rhymes. I'm gonna be a rapper. It's my only ticket out of the suburbs. Yo, yo, yo! Piotr!
Show business is a tough business, you know. For every superstar who hits it big, like Billy Ocean, there's probably dozens who don't make it.
You better not flunk out. I already rented your room to a boarder.
I'll call you Pants Boy.
How come Cindy didn't come with us?
Your sister's a junior now. I guess it's just not cool to show up with your parents.
Cindy, oh my God, you look so great. How was your summer?
It was wonderful. I quit drinking, and it changed, like, my whole self-image. What I discovered is self-respect.
That's awesome. Let's drink to being back at school.
Oh.
Here's a computer to help you grind the academic competition into a bloody pulp.
I bought you some of those rainbow pencils with the fuzzy tabs, just like you like.
Well, I don't know about this. What if I'm not smart enough to be here?
Down.
Is that our room? I bet you can see the whole parking lot from up there.
Hey, did you remember to pack an ass fur?
What's an ass fur?
Pooing!
Sanford!
And with this handsome globe we bought you, you won't be able to help but get straight A's.
I'm gonna try real hard. Hey, there really is a country called Poland.
Oh, that's fun.
A globe? That's just gonna clutter up the place.
We can put it in that corner.
That's where I was gonna put this pylon I found.
Boys, shouldn't you wait for your other roommate before you make these decisions?
Sanford and Dell? Your third roommate, Cal? The one you talked to over the summer? He died last week in a freak accident!
Woohoo! Ooh. We talked to a dead guy!
Honey, it's not like we're never gonna see him again.
I know, but it's the next best thing.
This place is style.
No doubt.
Dude, we're in, like, college or something. I could, like, throw mayonnaise all over the place if I wanted to.
I could wear this sombrero everywhere if I wanted.
I could eat this light bulb!
I could launch this bag of trash out the window.
Dude, that's my stuff!
What the hell? Jackasses.
For the first time, there's no one around to ruin our fun.
Hey, we didn't order that pizza.
Hey, we didn't order that, box.
I'm supposed to live here. Those incompetents screwed up my room assignment. I was supposed to get a single. I'm Joe.
What's that?
Ah! It's our dead roommate, Cal! And he knows what we did last summer!
That's my exact replica of the human skeleton. If you haven't figured it out yet, I'm going to medical school. Orthopedic surgeons start at about 400 grand.
That's it? You should be an ass doctor. They make a lot of money because they gotta touch people's asses.
Oh, God.
Welcome, and congratulations on your admission to Barter College. I trust you are all ready to meet the high academic standards of such a fine Ivy League institution.
This isn't an Ivy League school.
Yes, it is. It's an Ivy League school without all the bull crap. So what if they don't want me to be in their stupid club? Can we be any more immature? I don't need that kind of validation. I drive a Lincoln Town Car.
You know what the best thing about college is? Finally getting away from that crazy girl who stalked me all through high school.
Hi, Dell.
Felicity?
I didn't feel right the way we left things in high school, so I followed you to college. Now I go to Barter, too.
You're not supposed to be in the boys' bathroom, or within 100 yards of me.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll see you around then. Why did I follow him to college? It was stupid, stupid, Felicity. Maybe you'll learn if I pull out some of your beautiful hair. Ah!
Do you mind? I'm trying to read.
Me too. I can't concentrate without noise. Hey, what are you doing?
Enjoy your time in college, because it's not gonna last.
Dude, do you wonder if we're gonna, like, make it here?
The way I look at it, as long as they let you be a student here, I've got nothing to worry about.
Yeah, I guess that's a good way to look at it. I don't know what I was so nervous about. I'm gonna do just fine here. You didn't expect to see us up at the crack of dawn getting ready for the first day of classes, did you?
For your information, the semester started 3 weeks ago.
On the streets of Tokyo, the rules of racing have changed.
It's called drifting.
And if you want to win...
Who's the tourist?
I want to see what the kid's got.
You have to lose control.
Now what, Paul?
Come on!
The Fast and the Furious Tokyo Drift. Rated PG-13. Starts June 16th.
Thank you for being a friend.
What is your ball?
Go!
Road.
Get it going!
What is that?
Your heart is... You're a pal and a coast of dust. And if you're through a party,
take your time, guys.
Gift would be for me. Thank you for being a friend.
Command Robot Friends not fit for this world. Rated D for Teen.
Joe was right. We got dropped from all our classes.
No, we didn't. We still got this one. And we're right on time.
Oh, man. It's over. Hey, look. There's that guy from my room.
Let me ask you a question. 2 hours ago, when I said I was leaving for biology class, where did you think I was going?
That was the first choice again?
Don't listen to him. Just follow my lead. Nice speech today, Mr. Professor. Really hilarious stuff. My name is Sanford Riley. My friend, Del Swanson, and I are both deaf. We were concerned that perhaps you called our names for attendance these past several weeks, but didn't hear you because we are deaf.
I dropped you both last week.
What? I'm sorry. I can't hear you because we are deaf.
But, Mr. Professor, if you drop us, we'll flunk out. You've got to give us another chance.
What?
It's not our fault. We couldn't find the classroom. And then I dropped my fork. And Joe yelled at me. And then I realized I'm never going to see the back of my head.
All right, fine. I'll allow you to take Friday's exam. But you fail, and you two are on the next bus back to Palookaville.
Actually, we're from Canton.
I thought you were deaf.
Who said that?
I've got a problem. You have to get me out of that room.
Room 305?
No, the bathroom.
Oh, dear. Did somebody BM in the urinal again? This is perhaps the part of the job I enjoy least.
Listen, you little albino freak. I don't belong here. Barter was my safety school. How was I supposed to know Harvard had enough white males?
Well, we could fill out the roommate transfer form with all the proper signatures. It should only take about 12 weeks.
12 weeks? The semester will be over by then.
Want a thin mint? I bought a whole box, but it turns out they're too thick for my esophagus. It makes each one a little death cookie. Oh, man. How are we gonna pass this biology test? We've never been to the class. We don't even have the book. And neither of us has seen the movie.
Maybe we can ask Joe for help. He's smart, and unless I've horribly misjudged him, he's our best friend.
All right. Ask him.
You ask him.
No, you ask him.
You ask him.
I'm not gonna help you.
Help me? Or him? Him, right?
You two flunking out is the best thing that could happen to me. I'd get this room to myself.
Really? I think the best thing that could happen to you is getting laser surgery. 'Cause you've got such pretty eyes.
Now we're gonna flunk out and my mom's gonna be disappointed in me. This is just like high school. Well, except I didn't flunk out. And I didn't have any pubes. And there wasn't a guy across the hall mowing his carpet.
How could they let a guy like that stay in college and not us?
Oh, dang this dang thing!
Are you in that biology class?
Yeah, that test is gonna be a bitch though, ain't it? Well, I'll see you fellas around.
He must be some sort of rocket surgeon.
Or one of those idiot guys that can count real good. Like Everybody Loves Rain Man.
I think we just found our new best friend!
And that's how my mom died.
Classic. Hey, after dinner, what do you say we go over the review sheet?
Okay, how about number 5? Explain the different functions of xylem and phloem.
I have no idea. This stuff is way over my head.
Then how'd you get an A on that quiz?
He just gave me that because I was on a baseball team. I don't know any of this malarkey.
You mean we just wasted a whole week hanging out with you?
It wasn't a total waste. We still got these macrame doilies. I have some of this. My dad always told me, if you drink enough, the taste will go away. And a man's touch will be as tender as a woman's.
You had a long face, fellas.
We got a test tomorrow. We're gonna flunk out of school.
That's it? Relax. It's not the end of the world.
It's not?
Oh, no. Could be the best thing that ever happened to you. I used to pay $2,000 a year to come to this school way back when. Then I flunked out. Now they pay me $2,000 a year to come here. Who do you think got the last laugh there? Chuck's time to shine.
Hey, little brother. There's no food at my place. Can I borrow your meal card?
I already used mine tonight. Take Joe's.
What are you doing here? I thought I killed you.
That's Joe's medical skeleton. Sanford calls it Mr. Boner. And then he says, get it.
You get it?
Oh, I see. So, how's college treating you?
It's harder than I thought.
I wouldn't worry. You gotta be a real dolt to flunk out of this school.
Oh, God. We're screwed.
I don't want to be a dolt. What are we gonna do?
I guess we could try to read the chapters.
You always want to take the easy way out, don't you? Lucky bums. Never have to take tests. What do they know about hardship?
What are you doing?
Look at those two dogs!
Oh my God, look at that. That's disgusting.
Get a room! This should get a room.
Dear God, I know I don't deserve your help, but if you could possibly find some way for me to cheat on that test tomorrow, I'll forget about that $10 you owe me.
Del. I just happened to be outside your window the last 72 hours and thought I'd stop by. Is that biology?
Yeah. I have a test. So, I should probably get back to studying.
I aced AP biology last year. I could help you.
Really?
You could come over, and I'll tutor you in my room while we sit on my bed between my embroidered Dell pillows and look at my computer program that morphs our images and shows what our child would look like. I've already named him Delicity or Fel, whichever you like.
On second thought, I better just start to close this door as you struggle to keep it open.
You think I'm fat, don't you? I vomited 3 times for you today, you know that?
All right, let's hand them in so I can get home to my owls. Uh-huh, uh-huh, Uh-huh. You're on a roll, son. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Oh, there's a right answer. Oh, almost forgot.
They roll out the welcome mat for you, and the next thing you know, it's good riddance. And after we spent so much time building that loft...
What's the use? I don't belong here. I don't belong anywhere. I might as well just run off and join the Olympics. I can't seem to do anything right.
Those are Joe's clothes. That was the window.
Say, how'd you fellas do on that test? Bad, huh? Join the club. I think I got the lowest score in the class.
Wanna bet?
What'd you get? Oh, hell, a 42? At least you passed. I got a 15!
What do you mean, passed?
Our biology professor grades on a curve. He explained it on the first day. Weren't you there?
We can't be everywhere at once.
The lowest grade in the class gets the F. You guys got at least a D.
D? Do you know what that means?
Yeah, really big boobs.
Dude, your mom has D's.
And they're sweet.
You know what else it means? We passed.
Woo! College!
What are my clothes doing down on the... What the... Don't you know that thing costs over $2,000?
That thing has a name. Mr. Boner. Get it?
This is college. They don't tolerate brain-dead morons like you at this level of education.
I think they do.
Attention, swimmers. Or, swimmer. Got some announcements to make here. Sundays at 10, it's all kids out of the pool for adult swim.
You can't just decide to go swimming whenever you want.
That's when there'll be new, count them new shows. New shows. Oh, movies.
Who went wee-wee in my canteen?
Aqua Teen Hunger Force.
Look at my freaking car.
The Brack Show.
You foul.
Your father and race were...
Butts. Harvey Birdman, attorney at law. D-Lab 2021.
You broke the monitor, and you're dead. Happy.
Cowboy Bebop. Cowboy Bebop. And Space Ghost Coast to Coast.
This is Willie Nelson.
No kids under 17, though. So that's new, too. Sunday at 10. Adult Swim.
Dad? Dad, wake up. Dad, it's 9:15.
Could you do me a favor? Give me another 10 minutes and then really get on my case.
Dad, you got to get up and you go to work. You got a family to support. You want me to help you out?
You know what would help is if you could get the coffee going. That would be a big help.
Are you ill, Dad?
Oh, man, I just don't feel like moving.
Do you mind if I feel your forehead?
What, do I feel feverish to you?
Actually, you feel cold. Oh. Dad, you died last night.
Ben, thank you so much. This is a great cup of coffee.
Well, it's yesterday's. It was in the pot. I don't want you to start making a habit of this.
You think that I'm depending too heavily on the coffee?
I mean, no, not the coffee.
Oh, you don't want me to make a habit of sleeping late?
Yeah, I mean, this could be the start of something really bad for you.
You know what it's the start of? Maybe it's the start of me enjoying my life a little bit more.
I hate to put a fire under your fat ass, but get up and go to work and make money and then take care of me.
Well, you know, maybe the truth is that I am slowing down and that you're going to have to pick up the slack, carry the load a little bit.
If I'm going to have to start being responsible for you, mm-hmm. you know, I'm going to have to get you married off.
Ben, who's gonna marry me, though? Come on, man. I'm fishing for compliments.
Oh, right.
Who's going to marry a guy like me?
How about the next person that rings the doorbell?
Oh, you know, I like that game. I like that game. Remember we used to play the next person who gets off the elevator is going to be your true love?
Right.
Yeah. You still in touch with him?
People in the Midwest are definitely friendly. You know, like where I'm from, you'd wave to a stranger.
Mm-hmm.
And what I've heard is the further you get from a big city, the nice people are.
Well,
just like to walk through North Dakota, because I imagine I'd run into one guy who'd be like, "Hello, how'd you like to make out with my daughter?" Sure. You can kiss my daughter and I'll wave to you. Maybe growing up in Indiana wasn't the most dynamic place, but I made practical use of my time. Wrote a lot of poetry. Here's one of the poems I wrote. It goes something like this. Help, help, get me the hell out of here.
I like that.
Thank you.
What does your dad do?
My dad originally wanted to become a priest, but I knew he didn't have the temperament for it. It'd be like, never the father, the son of a bitch, damn it, pray.
Mm-hmm.
He's retired now.
Yeah.
That's my dad's cough, too.
Mm-hmm.
He actually gets it from smoking. My dad smokes constantly.
Yeah.
He refuses to go anywhere where he can't smoke. He could be at the gates of heaven. They'd be like, sorry, Mr. Gaffigan, no smoking in heaven. My dad would just be like, Jim, tell your mother I'll be in purgatory. Damn, son of a...
So this is just a guy who's a fixture in your neighborhood, and you're not sure that he's all there.
I was talking to him recently, and halfway through the conversation, I realized he was drinking a cup of gravy.
Mm.
You know, I like gravy, but I've never considered it a beverage.
Mm-hmm.
If you're drinking gravy, you're probably not like a big health nut. You know? Wouldn't you love to be at the doctor's office with this guy? Hey, how you doing there, Mr. Jones? I got your cholesterol here. You're aware your blood's not moving, right? Okay, this is kind of a weird question. You haven't been drinking gravy, have you?
Mr. Gottfried, you're 25 minutes late.
25 minutes late? This has never happened to me before! Oh, my God, I'm pregnant! You know, Jesus had a hard life.
Mm-hmm.
He really did because, you know, no matter what he did, he always had to be compared to his father. It's like being Frank Sinatra Jr. You know, wherever Jesus would walk, everybody would go, "Hi, Jesus, so how's your father? Your father's doing okay? That's nice." And he'd go, "But I want to save all of your souls." And they go, "Yeah, that's very cute. So your father's doing good? Your father's all right, then. You send our best to your father." You know, Mother Teresa, she worked very hard, but she can't be declared a saint because she didn't actually work a miracle.
Yeah.
She saves starving children. She goes and watches by bedsides, but she can't become a saint unless she works an actual miracle. So it's kind of pathetic that in the last years she was desperate for a miracle, and instead of helping starving children, she would go, "Hey, what's that behind your ear? Oh, look, it's a quarter. Yeah, let me take this starving child and saw him in half. Here's my lovely assistant, Denise, to show that there's no trick to this box. It's a solid box with solid chains on it. Hey, what card am I holding? Is it the Ace of Spades?"
It's up to Homer Simpson and family to save the world from a diabolical plot. Critics call it the best Simpsons game ever.
That's a lawsuit.
The Simpsons Hit and Run, rated T for Teen.
I am evil Homer.
I didn't think our marriage would survive.
It was really awful. Both of us kept everything pent up until one of us would just explode.
Hey, stupid! What kind of a meal was that?
Then we discovered Tekken 3. This is for 40 years of macaroni and cheese.
That's for never saying I'm sorry.
And this is for your mother.
That's for the loser that you are, Patrick. Thank you, Tekken 3. PlayStation.
Hello, I'm Robert Klein. I'm here to see Dr. Katz.
Could you have a seat, please? Could you please, no, stop it, please?
Woo-hoo. Sorry, Laura. Oh. It's just that I have to get ready for the doc, and I have enough
Could
on
I?
My mind.
No.
Laura! Laura!
Could you just please just leave me out of...
I just... It's so commercial, the world, Dr. Katz. Do people call you Dr. Katz?
Absolutely. But if you're more comfortable calling me... No, I think Dr. Katz is good.
George Washington was a brave man, and he risked a lot. And, mm-hmm. and I know that he'd be proud to know that we celebrate his birthday every year with used car dealers. I'm Bill Duncan from Bill Duncan Dodge, and I got a George Washington birthday sale that'll knock your socks off. Right, George?
That's right, Bill, and this poor actor Schmagaggy getting $90 with a rubber hatchet and a bad wig. That's right, Bill, I'm chopping down the prices on these beauties. It's a veritable cherry tree of savings.
Laura? Ben.
Yeah?
Ben Katz.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The younger Katz.
The annoying Katz.
Right, right.
What do you want?
He must have noticed how my father's lost, you know, that bounce in his step.
I didn't know that he had one.
Oh, he did, but it's gone.
Oh.
Yeah, now he just sort of meanders.
You know, wanders.
Very sad.
You know, I think if my dad retires, I think, well, you know, I'll get him a boat.
A boat?
Well, he'll get himself a boat, but I'll name it.
Mm. I love naming boats.
I do it all the time, in my spare time. Spare time is a good boat name.
Clever.
You know what's also a good boat name? Kicking Back. Uh-huh.
I have some trouble sleeping. I turn on the television. The only thing that can help me is watching QVC.
Mm-hmm.
Very lonely people calling at night.
Hello? Yeah, my daughter collects China facsimiles of northeastern cities. She needs Youngstown, Ohio.
I never heard of things that they sell. This woman is a big diamond-looking thing on him, but she didn't say it was a diamond. She said it's this beautiful diamondy ring... surrounded by two gorgeous ruby rosas. And there are three spectacular heart-shaped sapphire Eddos. Yes, beautiful sapphire Eddos with the ruby rosa and the diamondique.
The Communist Manifesto is not a good boat name.
Hmm.
It's not even a boat name.
It's the name of a book.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I read. Hmm. You know another bad name for a boat?
This piece of shit's gonna sink.
Well...
You know what?
Forget the boat. It's too difficult.
Hmm.
Waterlogged is pretty good. But yeah, forget it. Forget the boat. You know, I was doing a lot of thinking while you were gone.
Mm-hmm.
And, you're on your way out. What are we gonna do about it?
What about having a woman registered nurse come in once a week and bathe us? I think you're overreacting to my energy level, you know?
I was kind of thinking about what kind of old man you're going to be.
I think I'm going to be the kind of old man who can kick your ass until the day I die.
I mean...
That's the kind of old man I'm going to be.
You're certainly not going to be the distinguished gray type of guy.
No, I don't think that's in the cards.
I was thinking maybe you're going to be one of those old guys who, you know, just walks around, bumps into things until you sit him down. That type of guy.
I love those guys.
Maybe you're the kind of guy who just smiles all the time and has food on his chin.
Yeah, I don't think that's...
You can't
that's
take
not,
your eyes off it.
I'll tell you one thing, that at least I don't have an enlarged prostate like every other guy my age.
Is that a common affliction?
Yes.
Really?
It's the acne of the middle-aged.
The enlarged prostate?
Yeah.
What does that do to you?
Well, it puts pressure on your bladder.
So you have to pee a lot.
Yeah, and it puts pressure on your other organs to compete.
I mean, they all want to be bigger, too?
Yeah, and another thing that I'm grateful for... I never have had to use a deodorant in my entire life.
Is that so?
Yeah, I never did. My dad never did. We don't sweat in that way that has an odor.
You do have an odor. I mean, maybe you didn't realize it.
No, I think. Oh Lord.
Yeah.
Hello, Laura. Good to be here. I like wood. Wood.
Good.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I think a lot of this is all about body image and how you see yourself.
I am bald, blind, and pale. I'm like a large recessive gene. It wouldn't surprise me if I woke up tomorrow with a tail. Have you seen the comic with the tail? He's delightful.
Hmm.
People always know somebody that looks like me, you know. They're always like, hey, I know someone that looks like you. I never know what to say, you know. Tell them hi, you know.
Sure.
The only advantage of wearing glasses is you can do that dramatic removal. My God. People always want to try my glasses on, too. They're like, let me try on your glasses.
Mm-hmm.
That's rude, you know. I don't go to people with hair pieces. Hey, let me try on your wig. Let me sit in your wheelchair. Oh, my God. You are so crippled.
Well, the media is drawn to any kind of celebrity.
You know, we've even gotten to the point where we're interviewing the models.
Mm-hmm.
Dr. Katz, what do we expect to learn from a model?
I put lipstick on my lips.
Oh. Is there anything else?
I walk that way when they tell me.
We have so much to learn from you. You ever see one of these interviews? They're always like, you're very beautiful. How'd you do that?
My name's Kathy.
Okay, maybe you didn't understand the question. You're going out with a guy in a band, right?
Kathy. I go to the bathroom by myself.
Hi, I'm Gilbert Gottfried to see Dr. Katz.
Could you have a seat, please?
Yeah, Gilbert Gottfried.
I heard you.
Here, do you like impressions?
No.
You know, oh, good. Here, watch this. Jackie Gleason in Casablanca. You're getting on that plane with Vic Laszlo. Oh, you're getting on that plane, all right. As I know that you know that you're getting on that plane. You know, one time Hitler was making a big speech. And afterwards, when he got off stage, Napoleon came up to him and said, hey, you know that bit you do about taking over the world?
Mm-hmm.
And he goes, yeah. And he goes, well, that's my bit. And he goes, what do you mean it's your bit? I wrote that bit. And Napoleon says, no, that whole thing, I will be a leader. I will take over the whole world. I was doing that years ago. And he goes, don't tell me. I don't have to take your stuff. I write my own stuff. I don't need your material. And then they finally worked something out where Hitler said, well, look, if we're ever working in the same town, we won't both do the taking over the world bit.
I mean, Gilbert, I'm glad you're sharing this stuff with me, but I feel like we're just postponing the very thing that it is that you want to talk to me about.
Okay.
You know, there's nothing that you can't say in this room. Nothing will leave this room. It's called patient confidentiality.
But what if I say something particularly interesting? See, this is what bothers me. Nothing I say can leave this room. But what if I say something that's really interesting, that's really like a great quote, and then I'll know it just dies in this room?
Well, if it's something really great. Do you have any recurring dreams?
Unfortunately, this is something I wanted to talk to you about. My dreams have no symbolism. I want some symbolism in my... Everyone else has symbolism in their dreams. Everyone else has these dreams where all of a sudden there's a train conductor, but he comes out of a cake, and the cake is really like this girl I used to go out with, but the girl I used to go out with is actually my father. Me, I have these dreams where I'm walking down the street, and it's just a street.
Freud said that it's the dream...
He said this to you personally? I didn't think the two of you knew each other.
He said it's the dreamer.
But why was he speaking like you speak? Him being Freud, wouldn't he speak with a German accent?
Well, this is years ago.
Oh, so he didn't have the German accent back then.
Freud said that it's the dreamer, not the dream.
Well, did you turn to Freud? Did you take him aside at one point and say, what the hell are you talking about?
Okay, let's try something else. Let's try the word association thing. I'll say a word, and you say whatever pops into your head.
Butterfly.
No, I don't think you don't quite get it. I'm going to say
grasshopper.
Okay, well, let's
fountain pen.
I see you're way ahead of me. This is at a whole different level.
Shower curtain.
I think you win this round.
Yarmulke.
commence la vacance, les visions.
Un bonbon.
Qu'est-ce que c'est?
Stanley, let me ask you something.
Yeah, what?
You ever think about hanging it up, retiring, calling it quits, just...
Yeah, sure. Yeah, I think about that.
Kicking back and opening up a cold brew and...
This is a new side of cats.
Yeah.
What the hell is he talking about?
You know, I'll tell you why I'm asking you this, is because I feel like I'm physically slowing down. And Ben seems to think that the handwriting is on the wall.
What do the handwriting on the wall say?
He thinks that I should start phasing out of my work life and into my retirement life.
Nah. Why do you listen to him?
I don't know, because he's home? What am I thought about how I would like to die.
Uh-huh.
Because I do think about my own mortality quite a bit lately. Although, you know, there is a history of longevity in our family. My maternal grandfather lived to be 103. Every day he ate an entire raw onion and he smoked a cigar. 103 years old. You know what his dying words were?
What?
Nobody knows. I couldn't get near the guy. But still, I worry about death. Because it's, you know, it's waiting there patiently for all of us.
So you're saying I'm going to die?
Well, when you put it like that, it sounds bleak.
No, Dad, we're never going to die.
That's for other people.
We're the Katzes. We live forever.
Yeah,
well... Well, there's been a lot of death in the family lately, but I don't think that reflects.
Let's talk about something a little less morbid.
Yeah.
How's that tumor? What's all this stuff here, Ben?
Well, I got a surprise for you.
Is the
I guess
surprise...
I should have wrapped it.
Well, you know what gives it away is the easel and the paints.
Yeah.
You know?
So you knew what it was right
Immediately.
Away.
Immediately. I mean, I'm still surprised to see it in my home.
Oh, then that works out.
Yeah.
In a small way.
So why the paints?
You see, this is what I thought, Dad.
Yeah.
I decided to get you a hobby that's going to bring you through your old age.
You know, it's very sweet the way you're thinking, Ben. But it's a little misguided because you can't impose a hobby on somebody. It has to come from them.
Well, you know, sometimes...
You know, I have no desire to paint anything.
Well, now you don't, but if you started, I think...
I would like to put some tape over your mouth, though.
That's art, if you display it.
I don't have the hand-eye coordination for painting.
Well, you should give it a try.
And also, I'm colorblind.
Well, I only bought red.
Oh.
Is that red? Dad.
Yes.
You're up early.
Well,
I thought things were changing.
Time waits for no man.
What does that mean?
It means I like to get up. I like to seize the bull by the horns.
Well, you know, it's starting to sound like the old you.
I'm starting to feel like the old me.
Dad, you painted something.
Yes.
Last night.
Yes.
Wow.
What do you think?
It's
You know, it's a work in progress. I'm not done yet.
Yeah. But I mean, you gotta obviously.
I gotta sign it.
Doctor, this guy comes up to me and he says, "Hey man, you want to buy a watch?" I said, "No, I don't want to buy a watch, especially at a urinal. Now this is my time with myself. Do you know what I mean?"
Mm-hmm.
Maybe unconsciously I'll aim at a wad of paper in the urinal or a cigarette butt, try to separate it from the filter, pretend it's a Nazi installation.
Right.
You know, like a command decision, you know, "I'm afraid the photos from Bitburg were bad, sir. We'll have to go back and hit it again," you know.
Right. So is that your new watch?
There are a number of things I like about being Jewish. One is we bury quickly.
Right.
You know, I mean, a Jew dies, zoom, into the ground immediately. A Jew dies at noon, call the relatives in Phoenix. A funeral's at 2. Gentiles, they have awake 4 days, 5 days, 8 shows a day, like vaudeville. It's very uncomfortable for the family.
Mm.
Jews bury so quickly that old Jewish people are afraid to take a nap, lest they be mistaken for dead.
Who was the guy who was able to sell Hogan's Heroes to a network? I mean, who was able to walk into a network one day and go, "Okay, here's the idea. A group of soldiers held in a Nazi prison camp. It's a comedy!" That's interesting. Tell me more. Well, okay. You see, these soldiers are imprisoned by the Nazis behind barbed wire, and if they try to escape, they'll be shot. I love it. It's a laugh riot. Excuse me for being too pushy, but can you change your facial expression?
Oh.
Why are you sitting there with one facial expression? Please change your facial expression. Smile, frown, you know, do something, squint,
Gilbert, you know,
something. Just change your facial expression.
See, this...
I want this, you this to is... change your... You're staring
at... I have this fantasy when I retire that you and I are going to get a mobile home.
Mm-hmm.
And just see this great country of ours.
Like an RV?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But, you know, with a toilet, with a shower.
Oh, no. Forget that. We do it right. We do it the old way.
What's that, stagecoach?
Bareback. I'm telling you, Dad, we can take Mexico again.
It is at that time you'll find a nice lineup of shows. Sea Labs 2021.
I like my body. I love my body.
Space Ghost Coast to Coast.
Good one, Jace.
Good one, Jace.
Ah, now that's funny.
Home Movies.
Name's McGurk, and soccer's the game.
The Brack Show.
Brack, I can't see. Am I on the road?
Not really.
Cowboy Bebop.
How you doing, kid?
Aqua Teen Hunger Force.
Fella, what are you doing here?
Are you ready to rock?
And coming this January is Baby Blues. That's a new one for us.
How can you guys stand that noise?
But keep in mind, no kids under 17 allowed. Adult Swim, Sunday and Thursday at 10, only on Cartoon Network.
Insane. I'm all hyper and dizzy. Adrenaline. Like drugs, but legal.
I like it.
That was nothing. Once I got dared to tag a bus, during the day, while it was moving. I could have took the dirt sleep on that one, but hey, I fooled the heat.
Yeah, well, I almost got arrested once. Damn 5-0. Don't they have better things to do than hassle us?
You said it, man.
Really?
Oh, come on! That was so cool.
Almost there.
Oh.
Yeah, let me go again. Watch. True master. There you go.
Oh my god, Rudy, you're horrible.
So where's your sidekick, Mecca?
She, like, blew me off for some guy who doesn't even know she exists.
Damn. Matt's still a no-show. What's his problem?
I just hope he gets here before anyone I know walks by and thinks we're, like, together or something.
Hey, would you be so upset if someone thought you and Matt were hooking up?
Yeah, of course.
Good.
But not petrified. Not my fault. The trash can moved.
Don't sweat it, Chaka.
You okay? You're not yelling at me for hanging out here? You're not even gonna tell me I piss off the neighbors?
Nah, do what you want. Hang out. Piss on the neighbors if you want. I really don't care. I now know what it feels like to be on the other side of trouble. Oh, yeah.
was that my pain in the ass older brother or some kind of pod person?
Sorry I'm late. We ran into an art critic with a bat.
We've been waiting on your ass for like 45 minutes.
Please, we've only been here like 5. It took us forever to get downtown. There's this fire on the 456. Man, the trains are like all laid up between stations.
Laid up?
Yeah, I heard some workers saying they'll be there all night.
Sorry, I can't go with you guys then.
Huh?
Look, I have to go paint. Oh, I can do some really dope pieces. With a whole line laid up like this, they'll never have time to clean up a bomb train. They'll go right into service.
Oh my God, that's so illegal. Can I come?
Forget about it. He doesn't even let me go with him to paint. I do kind of prefer to go in alone. Come on, wouldn't you rather spend the night above ground and under me?
Please, just this once.
I could use a lookout. I guess it's okay. Two lookouts? You can carry the paint.
Shut up!
Jen, I'm not gonna turn into some lifeless shell of a man. There's still hope for me.
I mean, I want the rush of being young and stupid. We're not going bowling tonight. We're gonna do something cool, risky, crazy.
Alex, stop eating up the tape.
Leia? I thought no one was home.
I'm screening. I don't want to talk to this guy I have to break up with, but I'm waiting for this other guy to call. Plus, I have a date tonight, and you're clogging the line.
Well, where's Jen? Is she there?
No. She should be back any minute.
I'm coming over. I'll just sit around and wait for her, okay?
Whatever. Didn't you say something about wanting to do something crazy?
Yeah, I do, but not alone. I think I'm going through a midlife crisis or something.
Nah, you have to be old and bald and have a lot of money and a wife and stuff, like most of the guys I date.
I just feel like I've wasted my youth on stupid crap.
I totally know what you mean. Like, it took me until 18 to really take advantage of the fact that I was cute. What a waste. I've had boobs since the 6th grade.
So, when did you say Jen is coming back?
Oh, no.
Chill, okay? If any of the transit cops spot us, we're screwed. You know what I heard about those cats? I heard they have this blacked-out flatbed train that turns into a pit fight train at night. It's like blood sport. The strongest workers fight each other in some kind of, like, heavyweight death match.
You're a suck-ass liar. If they're so ferocious, then how come so many people are allowed to live in the subways? Because you know there's, like, 5,000 people down here with us. There are, like, whole communities of mole people with mayors and everything.
Come on, mole people?
Yeah, and farther down, there are people totally detached from reality who are, like, waiting for the apocalypse when everyone will have to go underground to survive. And they'll be ready because they have all this mac and cheese and crap. It's true, man.
I know one guy who saw an electric eel down here. He said it was the size of a small tree.
Really?
What's this? You believe him and not me? Come on, eel's my ass. Uh-oh, what the hell? Whoa, Achibi, really? The transit cops could easily catch that on their boards. There you go, getting all serious again. What is your problem tonight?
Oh, by the way, did I mention the third rail yet? Touch it, and the voltage fries you.
Like I don't know about the third rail. Is that the third rail from the platform, or the third rail from the wall?
Could you do me? You know, I would never wait around like this for someone I was dating.
Jen and I are not... We're just friends.
Right. And don't you care that your girlfriend never tries to look nice for you? She doesn't even wear lipstick.
She's not my girlfriend.
But what I really want to know is how come you guys don't do it here? You can, you know. I don't mind. I think this would look better without the bra, don't you?
Ah, 6th train. And not a moment too soon. I swear, Fruity. If we get busted because you tripped the circuit, it's okay. I've got enough fake IDs for all of us. What's up? Man, you scared me half to death.
What's up, Linus? Dude, your spider senses must be slipping, man. I've been watching you for like 10 minutes.
Hey, I guess my mind's on painting. You know, with the fire and all.
I understand. Who are the guests?
Some people.
Yo, man, I just heard folks talking about that water tower piece you painted last month.
What piece?
I saw kids taking flicks of it last week. You're like a hero, bro. Some are even saying that you're dead.
Really? Cool.
Yeah, man. People are sweating it. Anyway, take care.
Sub? Minus? You guys got stupid names.
Matt, man, you never told me about any water tower. Are there any other secrets you're keeping from me?
Put down the paint and step away from the train.
All right.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Auto, San Andreas. Out now on PlayStation 2. Rated M for mature.
This time, there's nowhere he can't go. In Spider-Man 2, the game, you have the freedom to go wherever you want, whenever you want. Use amazing new abilities to hop from blacktop to rooftop and save the city one crime at a time. Spider-Man 2, the game. Rated T for teen.
Sorry.
Damn! You trying to get us killed? Come on, we gotta bounce before that train clears.
Are we lost or what?
We're not lost. I just don't know where we are. Tell you what, why don't we call it a night? Get out of this hole and hit my pad for a few rounds of Tekken.
Hey, maybe I missed out on the stall trains, but I'm gonna paint tonight. Besides, we can't go back now. The transit guys are there.
How do I know you're not secretly a serial killer leading us to a dark corner? You're gonna sacrifice us to your new best friend, Sub?
Ferdy, are you gonna let a girl wanna go farther than you?
No. There's some weird sewer goo in here. I don't know about this.
Come on, man. There's a light at the end of the tunnel.
Yeah, well, you know what's gonna be at that light at the end of the tunnel? Another tunnel, that's what. Look, another tunnel.
Hello, it's like juvie center lighting in here.
Wow, this could be the unfinished P-Line I've heard about. It was abandoned like 50 years ago, but they still keep it lit up and clean. Well, mostly.
Why would anyone maintain some tube to nowhere?
Well, there are theories.
Really?
Yeah, like this is where the city trains its super secret hunter-killer robots. Or it's for weird experiments on people they swipe off the streets. Or it's for moving massive alien overlord brains in and out of the city. Wow, HAL 101. Back in the day, all the old school artists used to paint here. I thought it was just a myth.
It's like some kind of exclusive club without the drink tickets.
Damn, I'd love to tag in the P-Line.
Come on, there ain't no way I'm getting my new sneakers wet so you could catch a tag on some fella's pissing wall.
It's not a pissing wall. Just pretend you're in a hot tub. And if some stuff floats by, make believe it's bubbles.
Now I'm definitely not going in.
Suit yourself.
Damn. But I swear, if my balls get chomped on by some mutant eel or overlord brain, I'm gonna whoop you both with all my remaining limbs.
Oh, this isn't working either.
Yeah. Yeah, I think the other outfit was better. But Leia, you should get some shades. Some guy is watching you from across the street.
He is? Oh, he's always doing that. I think he's kind of cute. And he takes a cab home from work, sometimes 3 times a week. So he's got a good job. Come over.
You just invited him over? Are you crazy? And he's a stalker. The stalker with a good job. He could kill us or hire someone to do it for him.
Hey, you said you wanted adventure.
Yeah, but not like I'm gonna die adventure. I mean, I just wanted a little stealing a candy bar from the deli adventure.
Here, now do you feel better?
Get it over with already.
Gotta find the right spot, B.
If only all guys were like you.
Let's check this out.
Whoa.
Damn, these are like prehistoric. 1983? Oh, check this one out.
What? It just looks like a bunch of Smurfs. Oh, God, this is unbelievable. These are all the original masters.
Man, what's going on here?
Bilbo 125. Look, Krinsky 116. Those guys painted just for the love of it. Didn't care if anyone would ever see it.
Wow.
This is like a hall of fame, man.
What, can't get it up?
Uh-uh. My tag, with all the masters of the universe, I'm just not at that level yet. I mean, I've never even been to jail.
And someone called you a hero? You're just a regular sucker like the rest of us.
Hey, speak for yourself.
Leia, I think I've had enough excitement for one night. I'm gonna go home now. Jen.
Hello?
Hello?
That's not Jen.
Alex, if you're gonna hang out, could you wait in my room? I don't want him to know there's another guy in here, even if it is just you.
Well, I would feel bad if I left and your head wound up in a shoebox. So I'll be in the next room listening. I mean, listening for trouble, in case you're in trouble.
Hi there.
Hi. So this is what my apartment looks like from the inside.
And Echo, you know, well, like, there's this whole movement of people in Germany now that copy his style.
Excuse me, people. Are we just gonna stand here all night and look at these damn pictures? You know, there's farm animals out there with no balls having more fun than I am right now.
You're so vulgar. God, why can't you just admit that your best friend is cool and he does cool things? Nobody begged you to come here in the first place.
Man, what's the big deal anyway? It's just a bunch of scribbles. I could do just as good. Stand back, Junior. Watch the master do his wild style.
Hey, man, don't be stupid.
You ass! This is why I never bring you with me. This is why I didn't tell you about that mural. Because I knew you'd be jealous and you'd act like this.
Hey, I'm not jealous.
Oh, you'd screw up for sure. Like you led the transit cops to us. And like you're screwing up right now.
You're going crazy, man. Getting all up in my face with your rules and regulations.
Yo! Chill! Yous are worse than a couple of girls, man.
This is why I go in alone.
Hey, Matt, chill out. He didn't mean it.
I said, this is why I go in alone.
Who needs him anyway?
Man, what am I doing? Going my new sneakers.
Where the hell are we? Ugh, I'm cold. Don't touch me.
Man, he's so caught up on some Vincent Van Picasso Monet crap. I'm tired of this. On top of that, all night he's been dissing me.
With your attitude, who wouldn't? Oh my... Ew. That sewer slime is, like, everywhere in there. Are you sure we shouldn't just go back and find Matt?
No way. We're taking the slime.
Ew, gross.
And what kind of best friend is a person like this? It's worse than the time he abandoned me on the side of the highway. We borrowed a friend's car to go to Philly this one weekend. And in the middle of nowhere on I-95, Matt pulls over. I gotta paint now. He just jumped out of the car and dashed with his wrecked up plane. Took the keys with him and all, just left me in a sea of cows.
God, I am so sick of hearing you talk about Matt. What, are you, like, in love with him or something?
Don't be saying stuff like that.
Fruity. Oh!
Hey, that's not funny.
He's outside.
Your real date?
Yes, Alex, why didn't you tell me this would happen?
Who's he?
The next guy in line. No, I'm kidding. I'm a friend of the roommates.
Oh, so you're doing the roommate.
I am not doing the roommate. She's just a friend.
Okay.
God.
You two stay in here until I leave and keep totally quiet. The kinky stuff is in the middle one. Shh.
What's that?
Nothing.
Shh.
It's like a tagger's heaven. All these trains just laid out. Come on, you've got to go get Matt and bring him here.
Uh-uh. He gets nothing from me.
Verdi, this is like his dream.
Friend traders don't have dreams. They have nasty little fantasies while they're awake.
Fine. Then I'm going to get him myself.
Uh-uh. No way. I saw it first.
Oh, this is great. Finally in sight. Perfect spot. And the damn zip is stuck.
Matt! Guess what? We found a train yard.
I found the train yard, partner. There's dozens of them, just sitting there.
You're not messing with me?
Nope. Then let's hit it. But you gotta know, I'm not telling you about this because I forgive you for dissing me.
Yeah, that's okay.
And I didn't diss you because I was feeling left out or anything. You deserved it.
I know.
As long as you know.
Why are you guys pushing each other?
We're not. And then the value of my portfolio increased 5%. So you see, future speculation can be really cool. So you want to check out the middle drawer?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Hey, Lair, what was that? Who's talking?
Oh, yeah.
Uh-oh.
How could they find us all the way down here?
First the power switch, and now the goop.
I told her we shouldn't go the way with the sludge.
That's so wrong!
Don't move! Forget him!
Get the other two.
I can't believe he just ran. Ow, let go. Please?
Don't do anything stupid, kid.
Damn, I'm gonna kill Fruity.
I really hope there is a giant eel, and I really hope it gets him.
Come on, let's get at it.
Come on.
Get him! What took you so long, huh?
You suck.
Man, I haven't felt so betrayed since the time you took the car and left me stranded on I-95.
Settle down, man. I ran and flipped one of the power switch things I tripped over. Remember? That was when you told me I screwed up for the first time.
Nice.
Yeah, right. It was probably just a coincidence.
A coincidence? That happened at the exact same time in the exact same tunnel? Please.
It could have been a friendly neighborhood mole person.
Look at that. We're in Queens, across the entire East River.
That was crazy. We don't even have to make up a good story to go back with.
You know, even though I didn't get to tag Jack, I still had fun.
Yeah, well, if it wasn't for me, you wouldn't even have had the chance to paint those trains.
Excuse me?
Okay, but who saved your asses from those flubber cops? That's right, who's the hero now, huh?
What is going on here?
I'm not getting any, I swear!
What about him? Are you dating him too?
I would say dating is too strong a word.
You telling me the truth?
It's the truth, really. I mean, look at him.
Leia, look. I know you'd rather chew off your arm than have a relationship conversation with me, but we gotta talk. Leia, pick up the phone. Or don't. Fine.
What?
I figured you were cheating on someone with me, but going behind two guys' backs, that's just too much.
You are dating with the one on the phone also? My God, Leia, this is crazy.
Yeah, craziness.
Come on, please.
In my country, only men can be with more than one man.
Hey, you shut up.
Who the hell are you?
Just shut up.
Who's your sucker?
You don't want
to. What's going on?
Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah? Don't even look at me, you.
Sorry I'm late.
No, I've been waiting for you. I was all set to do something risky and exciting.
I would have been home sooner, but the damn train from Queens got shut down by a power outage. So, what do you want to do?
Now? I'm exhausted and I want to go to bed.
Ooh, with or without a nightlight.
Hey, I've had enough of crazy. Your roommate is in there with two guys and the third one's on the phone and they're all fighting.
Really?
It's a hotbed in there. I would avoid your place if I were you.
No way, this is what I live for.
Damn, I can't believe we made it through that one.
Yeah.
Heard.
Matt, what time is it?
Past midnight.
Oh, man.
No way.
Yeah.
What are we doing out here?
Our night is gone.
Nah. Look at my sneakers. What?
Ah, the goo gotcha. How was your night, man? Turn out like you wanted?
Oh, it was insane. There was cheating and nudity, fights, lipstick stains, imprisonment in a bedroom. Oh. How about you guys?
We had a pretty mellow night. Nothing special.
Yep, just hanging out. Hey, should have come with me. You really missed out. Poor Alex, making up stuff just to impress us.
What was that? Why didn't you tell him that I saved you all like He-Man?
Oh, you must
Who's
be
the man? Who's the hero? Yeah. Yes,
you
kiss my hand, man. Please.
For real.
I beg
hero.
My
hero.
Ass.
Whatever.
Give it up. Yeah. Give me the respect, dude.
Start like.
Give me the respect that you owe me.
Which you should give me, which I shouldn't have to ask this? You for.
Come on, give it up.
Who's the man?
Aqua Teen Hunger Force. Here's Frylock, the potato man. Frylock's the smart one. Now let's meet Meatwad. He's not smart, but he's cute. People relate to Meatwad, especially stupid people. Uh-oh, here's Mr. Shape.
Dancing is forbidden.
What an a-hole. Say hello to neighbor Carl. He's impotent. That must be hard on Carl. Why not spend an evening with the Aqua Teen Hunger Force right here on Adult Swim?
Thank you.
God! I didn't mean to! I've soiled the centerfold!
Ruined, Cornfed. The work of all those dedicated professionals coming together to capture a natural woman at an unguarded moment.
Interesting use of a spatula.
Ah, she's perfect, Corny. Can you imagine having a woman like that?
They're overrated, Duckman. I dated a model once.
You're kidding! Lingerie?
Corrective footwear. But they're all the same. The look promises a night of comparing hard-to-find birthmarks in a hot bubble bath, but all you get is a slap in the face and a cold shower.
How hard a slap?
The letters are a hoot, though. I'm constantly amazed that some pathetic loser is so desperate that he'd write a publication like this for advice.
Yeah, can you believe it?
Look at this one. Dear editor, I can't get a date and I don't know why. I'm so hard up that I've started collecting Swedish magazines, nude volleyball videos, and inflatable meter maid dolls. Any advice? Signed, a middle-aged duck detective. I wonder where I put that stapler.
Wait a minute. You think that's me? There must be a million middle-aged duck detectives out there. This is just one of those crazy coincidences.
Red Zone, you've been a bad boy.
The things the former owners left in these closets. Okay, so I've been a little inactive since, you know, Beatrice died. I've been wanting to jump back in lately. Women just haven't been responding to me. But it's a big world, Corny. There's a lot of possibilities out there. It's only a matter of time before good luck's gonna come my way.
Wrong thermometer, isn't it?
What the hell's going on? Where am I? And what the hell happened to my voice?
You can't talk, so I installed Mr. Tracheotomy. It must be on the wrong setting.
Well, I don't give a...
Flying late through a rolling donut, what you installed or what setting it's on!
I just want my own damn voice back!
Oh.
You know, while I'm fixing your bill, I could make some adjustments. Judging by your x-rays, it is a tad on the small side.
Small? I've seen plenty of guys with smaller bills than me. Not that, you know, I look at other guys' bills.
Suit yourself. I'm sure there are women who respond to a smaller bill. As soon as we get the okay from your insurance company, we'll get you fixed right up.
Buy you bills, Gumbo, and insurance. Uh-huh. Was the thermos full or empty? Nope, not covered.
Oh, get off me, sphincter face!
Cornfed, do you think I'm attractive?
Sorry, Duckman. I don't date people I work with.
No spam for brains? Do you think there's anything wrong with my bill?
You mean the fact that it curves to one side, the nostrils don't match, it's covered with nicotine stains, acne scars, varicose veins, and it whistles when you chew? I mean, no, nothing I can see.
Ow! Ow! Ow!
Hey, Don. You're home late.
Homely? My own flesh and blood calls me homely? You know how that makes me feel? It makes me feel the way you must have felt when the other kids voted you the ugliest kid in your class. I can't believe you'd call me homely.
Actually, Don, I said you were home late.
Oh. You know, I think that Blevins kid is uglier than you.
Thanks, Don.
Ow!
Hey, kids, let me ask you something. Do you think your old man's attractive? Bernice, I want your honest opinion. Do you think I'm attractive?
I could answer that, but that would mean having to look at you.
I need some air.
Are you insecure about your looks?
Why would I be insecure about my looks?
So you're defensive?
Maybe a little.
Do your friends think you're ugly?
Yep.
How about your family?
Check.
Co-workers?
Affirmative.
Blind people?
Uh-huh.
Sideshow freaks?
Anyhow.
People whose faces have been mangled in industrial accidents?
Bingo!
That's because you are! And nobody likes ugly people. Not in our society. Not in any society. So there's only one thing to do. Take your own life. No, I'm kidding. Well, now there's a cure for ugliness. Through the magic of cosmetic surgery, I can help you become the beautiful person you deserve to be. Come on in for a fanny tuck, chin cleft, maybe even a bill extension. And don't wait too long. No one wants to be old and ugly. Mention this ad and get 10 minutes of free liposuction.
Bill extension, bill extension, bill extension.
Women just haven't been responding.
It is a tear on the small side.
The nostrils don't pinch.
Women just haven't been responding.
What's the ugliest part of your body? What's the ugliest?
Hi, I'm Dr. Levine. You must be Duckman.
Doc, can you help me?
Oh, of course I can. Put this bag on your head and pray it doesn't blow off. Just kidding. Whoa, whoa. Duck. Step into my office. Mr. Duckman, one look and I can see why you're here. Pec implants.
No, I...
Those massive eye wrinkles.
Well, I...
Butt lift.
Hey, look!
That unsightly flab around the...
I want a bill job!
Had to be, the rest is perfect. Shot in the dark. Kind of guy who wants to see the most expensive models, right? This first one's the Airstream, tends to flap a little, but it is heat resistant and doubles as a lawn chair for outdoor sporting events. The Longfellow, real Corinthian leather, easy to patch. We recommend dry cleaning after Italian dinners. And of course there is the Magnum, but between you and me, I'm afraid it's a bit more than most people can handle. What with all those beautiful women wanting to fondle it in public places and such?
I can handle it. Give me the Magnum, please, 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 please. Wow.
Oh, this is just a contract with a little paragraph saying the bill may cause cancer, kidney failure, blindness, deafness, and dandruff.
Dandruff?
Comes with a special low-cost shampoo.
Sold!
Yo.
Your style is generic. Mine's authentic made. I roll like a renegade.
To listen to the individual, the metaphysical
voices, the fiery chain.
313 area bound to bury it within.
Who want what? Who pumped up to get rolled
up? So here I go, it's my son. Beat fam and I. This may be the only opportunity that I got. You better put this down in the music. The moment you hold it, you better never let it go.
Something's gonna happen. It needs to happen now.
Rated R at theaters Friday.
Morning, Fluffy. Uranus. Notice anything different?
Did you get new glasses?
Lose weight?
Comb your hair?
No, you little road apples. I got a new bill.
Poor misguided Mr. Duckman. You don't need to mutilate your body just to meet some vain standard of superficial attractiveness.
We look past all that to see your inner beauty.
Mm-hmm. Time to see your inner beauty.
Fine-looking honker, Duckman.
Oh, you noticed, huh? I don't know why I didn't see it before, Corny. This is the reason I haven't been getting a second look from the babes. It's what's outside that counts. Women are still after the same darn thing.
Someone who leaves the toilet seat down?
Looks. Like that stewardess you used to date. You two wouldn't have been smacking the sheets if she thought you were a mud fence. Am I right?
Actually, we never quite went all the way.
What? You went with her for over a year. How far'd you get?
She hugged me when we broke up.
What about the aerobics instructor?
Nope.
The hairdresser?
Nope.
Golf instructor?
Nope.
The heiress?
Nope.
Crossing guard?
Nope.
Synchronized swimmer?
Nope.
The ice sculptor?
Nope.
The ex-nun?
Nope.
How about when you got snowbound in that cabin with the nymphomaniac and wanted to get back at her parents?
Second base. There's something you should know, Duckman. I never told you because I'm a little sensitive about it. I'm a virgin.
A virgin! Unbelievable! You! No in-ski, out-ski! No bufferino! Never nailed the hammer on the head!
Ready to get on with your life now?
Ah, look, don't worry about it. This is the new and improved Duckman. I'll take you under my wing, show you how it's done. Maybe even throw you a few leftovers. Just stand back. Watch a master at the top of his game.
I'm Fantine. And I'm Cosette.
We've been celibate for a year, and we need you to go out with us. Don't worry, we'll pay you. We can't trust men. We've always had trouble finding any who will appreciate us for more than our looks. No matter what we do, they just see us as objects of their sexual fantasies, and we need to find out what we're doing wrong. You have a cookie crumb on your left breast. There's a little piece of chocolate on yours.
Come in. I'm Duckman, and this is Hooters. I mean, Cornfed. This is Cornfed. Sorry, just a little horny. Tired this morning. A little tired. Can we get you anything? A cup of coffee? A cup of decaf?
We're practically bursting to start dating again, but we're afraid we'll attract the kind of man who made us stop in the first place. So we want you to investigate us. Tell us how to change before we attract someone we might regret. All you have to do is watch us closely. Tell us what we're doing that makes men focus on our bodies rather than our minds. Oh, I dropped my earring. Oh, there it is. We just want to be appreciated for the right things. You must know what it's like. People probably come on to you because of your bill. I'll bet some people even ask if it's real. Don't you hate that? Oh, the nerve. Well, off to give each other a full body hot oil massage. If you're interested in the case, meet us at this address. Say, 7-ish? Your skirt is clinging. When you have some of those lint balls again.
We can't go.
I'm sorry, it must be the new bill. I thought you said we can't go.
I did. We're knee-deep in real cases. We can't just drop our heavy workload and go out on a date. Well, you never know what'll come up when we're gone.
Duckman, we have to go. I need to learn how to awaken the sexual beast that lies dormant in every woman's soul, waiting to transform her into a lusting creature of unbridled passion, pulling at me, tugging at me, yelling, "Take me, Cornfed! Make me your love slave!" You know, that sort of thing.
I said no, Cornfed!
Chicken.
Virgin.
Chicken.
Virgin.
Chicken, 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 chicken.
Virgin, 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 virgin!
Chicken.
Virgin.
Chicken.
Virgin.
Chicken, chicken, chicken.
Halo. Virgin, 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 virgin. Virgin, virgin! Virgo! Virgo!
Chicken.
All right, look! I don't want to hear another word about it. We're not going, and that's that! Get these things off of me!
Duckman, you think the women will be able to tell I'm not experienced?
Oh, will you shut up? No one can tell by just looking.
Next up on the first hole, Virgin plus three.
Hi, Corny. Hi, Duckman.
The radiator wears civil cheese.
We thought the burlap sacks would be a good idea. Men always seem to respond to our outward appearance, so we didn't want to dress like sex objects.
Since we've been hired to observe your behavior, the concept of men always allowing women to go first tends to reinforce the notion of helpless playthings.
Ooh, he's perceptive.
Mini-golf put me through dental school.
Duckman, I guess you're next.
Racers don't walking in, sombrero.
Here, let me help steady your putter. Uh-oh, my chest is rubbing against your back. Oh, that probably gets you thinking about our bodies again, doesn't it? Is it my turn? Oh, I've got a cramp in my neck. Duckman, can you rub it for me?
Sorry about last night. I forgot all about that appointment with my periodontist. Miss anything?
We went back to their house.
Their house? Details! Give me details!
A-frame, 2.5 baths, exposed brick fireplace.
No, you idiot! What happened?
We played Twister. I lost. Beyond that, I am a gentleman. If you'll excuse me, I'm off to help Cosette and Fantine learn why men focus on their bodies while they sponge wash their car in cutoffs.
I need some air.
Thought cosmetic surgery was the answer, didn't you? Well, it wasn't, you insignificant worm. If you want the real answer, come in and see me. I'll teach your problems the meaning of discipline.
Mention this ad for 2 minutes of free body piercing.
Women just haven't been responding to me.
Chicken.
Here, let me help steady you, Potter.
Imagine having a woman like that.
Ooh.
No way. This time I'm not gonna do something just because a commercial tells me to.
Yes, you are.
Give me your dirty love.
That's all for today, Mr. Cooper. You're making admirable progress.
You, Duck, you're next.
I don't know about this. It's kind of hard telling my problems to a woman.
Don't worry. I used to be a man. Here, lie down on this. Spill it. This isn't nap time.
Well, I've been having some problems.
Just a second. Okay, so you have some problems.
With women, actually.
You're not sexually active.
I'm very sexually active.
With another person.
Oh, no.
Ah, I know exactly what this calls for. You're getting sleepy.
No, I'm not.
Now?
Not really. Let's try the watch again. Where the hell am I?
You're going into your psyche. Everyone's psyche is like a house. Some have a two-story colonial, others have a country cottage, depending on how your mind works. There's yours. Wait, psyche is very difficult to understand. Entering it can be an incredibly complex procedure. Of course, some are less complex than others. Duckman, come back here!
Looks like the honeymoon suite where Beatrice and I stayed. A little more tasteful, maybe.
You, ducky.
Wow, there they are, just waiting for me. And I can't do a thing about it. Hey, I don't have to be scared anymore. This is my fantasy. Yahoo! Ah-ha! Incoming!
Gee, Duckman, we're sorry. We didn't plan for that to happen.
That's okay, don't move. I'll get a ladder, put on the tights, be up there faster, and you can say three-way circus.
Not working, huh? I'd say the fantasy part of your psyche's been a little overtaxed lately. I think she's right. After all, we've had a little experience being in people's fantasies. And we've found when unfulfilled realities overtake a libidinous subconscious, the disparity between the two manifests in a breakdown of the gestalt.
Huh?
No confidence. You'd better go find it. Your fantasy will never become reality until you get your confidence back.
Okay. Couldn't we try just one little somersault into my lap?
Maybe the trollops are right. Confidence is the third door on the left.
Hey, Dad, guess who's gonna take care of you when you're old? Me.
Duckman, Bubala, come on in. I'll make you some soup.
I don't have time!
Fine, go. What do you care about anyone else? Play mini golf with your floozies and just leave me here to die.
Don't get her mad.
Who said that?
I did. I'm your confidence.
You? But you're puny, you're scrawny, you're pathetic. Snappy dresser, though.
You don't want to know from him. He's been beaten down by your guilt.
What do you know about it?
I'm your guilt! Ah! Did you think you could get away with dating those other girls behind your wife's back?
Beatrice has been dead for a year and a half!
Maybe, but I'll be with you for the rest of your life!
Don't worry, I'll save you. All right, could just wait over here while you save yourself.
Beatrice? Is it really you? Wow, you look great. Did you lose weight?
Well, I am dead. How are the kids?
Fine, fine. Look, this guilt is killing me. Can't you ease off just a little?
I'm not doing anything, sweetheart. This is your mind, remember?
But the guilt is because of you! I haven't, you know, seen anyone since you died. I didn't think you'd like it.
Duckman, thank you, but that isn't any way to live your life. Remember staking out that vendor at the parade the day you accidentally caused my death?
One guilt at a time, okay?
Sorry. The point is, I wasn't expecting anything to happen. But when your cigarette punctured the Bullwinkle float and he started losing helium until his antler dipped into the clown car and sent it crashing into Puff the Magic Dragon, who bounced off Snoopy and knocked me into an open manhole, killing me, I realized this could happen to anyone. You never know when it's your time, Duckman. You should do what makes you happy now.
He should?
And you don't have to change your bill to make you happy. I liked it better before. It was more regal.
Regal?
I loved you exactly the way you were. I'll always be here. You'll always remember. But you have to move on. You're the one who's still alive.
You won't need that fire where you're going, lady.
You forgot your son's birthday last week.
Goodbye, Duckman.
Goodbye, Beatrice.
Oh, we're up.
You cured me. I got my confidence back. I slayed the dragon of guilt. Now I'm ready to go out and breathe a little fire of my own.
Ah, the wondrous and mercurial vicissitudes of the mind.
I'm back. Got the old bill, a new attitude, and I'm ready to take on the world.
Mr. Duckman, this came for you earlier.
Dear Ducky, Cornfed's a little worn out from observing us all day. Thought you might want to take over. Truth is, ever since you resisted us last night, we've been looking to spend more time with you. No one ever plays hard to get with us. Signed, the twins.
How about a ski weekend? Just the three of us, all alone by a fire.
Wasn't just once a month. I sure do love science.
Well, I guess it's just the way it has to be, Tommy. Reverend Putty's a very busy man.
All right, settle down, everyone. Who can remember February's lesson? Oral?
We learned that the solar system is made up of 10% gas, 20% sin, and 70% heaven-flavored afterlife.
Very good. Any questions on that? Doughy.
Is sin radioactive?
Yes. That's why it's dangerous to get it near your groin.
Yikes!
But Reverend Putty?
Yes, Tommy?
I thought 4% of the universe is made up of atoms.
Tommy,
and...
can't you listen?
But I read in a book.
Well, I read Dracula in a book. But that doesn't mean I believe in Transylvania. Oh, Okay, this baking soda represents angels, this vinegar represents God's will, and this bottle is...
The Holy Ghost?
No.
The Holy Spirit!
Yes, and when they're mixed together, we see how God created the earth 6,000 years ago.
Oh, boy. Wow. Oh,
that's a long time. In fact, 6,000 years is the longest time there could ever be.
But then, how does time keep going?
Here's how. And I'll see you after school.
Hey, Tommy, wanna play Super God? Oh, I don't mind being the deviler this time. It's only pretend.
Devil me this, Super God!
Well, do you think I'm stupid? Well, I think that it's just... God is perfect, right? And God made you, so you must be perfect just how you are. I don't know. I try to understand what Reverend Buddy teaches, but sometimes it just doesn't make sense to me. Well, I can tutor you. Hey, that's a great idea. You soak in everything he says like a sponge. Yeah, and I can make your brain a sponge, too. Now let's play. Okay. Da-da-da, regular God, mild-mannered and all-powerful, creator of the universe. But at a moment's notice, he can become... Super God! More powerful than all-powerful, can create a rock so heavy that even regular God can't lift it!
Well, quite frankly, Mr. and Mrs. Littler, your son Tommy scored poorly on his IQ test.
Oh, dear.
I don't understand. He's always studying.
Studying doesn't help with IQ tests. That's why it's the perfect measurement for how stupid he is.
How stupid is he?
Very. You see, these questionnaires were developed by professors at Morrilton University. Take a look.
Complete the pattern. Flower, bud, stem, seed.
God's giggles.
Pretty straightforward, eh?
And he got that wrong?
Well, his answer was... pollination.
That's moronic.
Now, moronic is a harsh word and not socially acceptable anymore. We prefer to call your son retarded.
Oh, my Tommy.
Although it's exactly as bad as it seems, the consolation is that we do have a class here at Diorama Elementary that will generously condescend to his lack of mental capabilities.
With a qualified teacher?
Qualified? Oh, no. We can't waste those. But we can assign him a brain buddy to keep him from spazzing out in public. Oral!
Yes, Principal Fakey?
Report to my office immediately!
Hot dog! I'll be right back, Tommy!
What kind of sandwich do I have today, Mom?
Bologna! And I'm packing some potato chips, too. Happy-dee-dee!
What are you doing?
Well, we don't want you to choke now, do we?
I'm not gonna choke.
Get ready. Oral will be here soon.
Oral? Hey, I'm not taking my bike, Mom.
Of course not. You're not allowed to ride that thing ever again.
Morning. Ready for school, Tommy?
Take care of him, Oral.
What's going on?
Bye, Mrs. Littler.
Bye, Tommy. I love you.
Here we are.
Oral, what's going on? This isn't our class.
No, but it's your class now. I hear it's nice.
But... Well. This little smarty pants must be Tommy, mustn't he? I am your new teacher, Ms. Stoopdown, and these will be your new only friends from now on. So you see, children, God created numbers to count things for us when our brains get tired. Number 2 counts 2 things. Number 8 counts 8 things. Does anyone know what number 6 is good at counting? Very good. 6 things. Oh, look, the big hand has hit another number. That means I get to have another break. See you in 2 numbers.
I'm not retarded.
Yes, you are. You're religiously retarded, like us.
Yeah, we're curious.
Don't say that.
It's true, face it. We have open minds.
Yeah, we don't accept anything on faith.
The coast is clear. Come on, let's read.
Oh, good. Come on.
Hurry before she gets back.
Here, Tommy.
Oh,
thanks.
Gods.
Knucklehead.
Godtard.
Sorry I'm late, Tommy. Let's go.
Hey, Arl. What are you doing hanging out with this Goofy Toons?
Yeah.
He's tutoring me.
Tutor? You? You're a lost cause. Why, you don't even know how many Ten Commandments there are.
ten of them.
Tickle, tickle, ow. Tickle, tickle, ow. Tickle, tickle, ow.
Mom, God is perfect, right? Yes. He's the most handsome, understanding, and satisfying man a woman could ever ask for. Oh, but what about... Oral, are you trying to make me feel inadequate about my marriage? Gosh, no!
Stinking dead-end job.
Hello, sweetheart.
There's my gal.
Hey, Dad, can I talk to you?
Sure. In my study.
Okay.
You don't seem at all nervous, young man.
But I didn't do anything wrong.
Oh, right. Well, I guess my belt can have the day off. Darn it.
Dad, I'm a little worried about my new responsibility of taking care of Tommy.
The half-wit, eh?
Yeah, I'm confused. God made him, but I can't think of why he'd do a thing like that to Tommy. Can God make mistakes?
Glad you asked, Oral. God makes two kinds of mistakes. The first kind is called a miracle. You know, bleeding statues, burning bushes, earthquakes, and hurricanes that destroy disgusting foreign cultures. Those are all good mistakes that back up our faith in positive ways. Then there are his not-so-good mistakes. The common cold, traffic jams, and the mentally retarded. They're called God's blunders.
But how can God be omnipotent and make blunders?
Well, when I say words like mistakes and blunders, you miss my sly little wink. That wink means we don't understand everything about God. All we do know is that when he goofs up like that, it's just an illustration of the spookiest commandment of all. The Lord works in mysterious ways.
Yikes. So that's what that means.
You betcha. Those mistakes test our faith.
Wow. Thanks, Dad. You helped a lot. But how is that a commandment? You really don't have to walk me every morning, Oral. Look, Tommy, I like it. It helps me test my faith.
You should understand the Bible, stupid.
Yeah, like Abraham begat Isaac.
Or blessed are the meek.
Yeah, he who's without sin.
Hey, they're hurting my friends. Tommy, wait! Normal kids! Listen to me!
Get lost, Oral. We're playing missionary.
Wait, everyone, please! Listen up. Just because these kids are different, that doesn't mean we should treat them badly. I mean, golly, if God loves them for their inadequacies, then we should too. You see? God loves everyone! Even the stupid and retarded, like these poor children. Because as hard as it may be to believe, God wants them this stupid. Yes, these children are not as lucky as we are, but we shouldn't ridicule them. We should pity them with all of our love and patience. For we all know God is perfect, so they are perfect. Perfectly stupid. Perfectly.
Sorry, Ken.
Yeah, you're sad.
Oh, yeah. Poor guy.
Oh, boy. Well, at least his heart's in the right place.
Poor kid.
Poor kids. Oh.